What's going on, danglers? Welcome to another episode of Quick Shifts, where we bring you everything that you may have missed in the NHL last night. Now, usually the way that these things work out, we highlight some dangles, some snipes, some sellies, some fights. We're going to change it up a little bit today. We're going to pay our respects to the art of the chirp using this absolute mic drop from Vancouver versus Calgary last night as an example.
Curtis Lazar comes in to help. Prestige, stick chopped out of his hands, can't play it. Wanted the glove it back, but that would have been a whistle. Tried to kick it, but the Canucks take control and work it out. Zanich over the line, work it out. Zanich over the line, work it out. Zanich over the line, work it out. Zanich over the line.
Holy shit, buddy, you really went right in there for that one. I mean, usually with the chirp, you start off, you go after the guy's skill. You call him a pigeon. You call him a grocery stick. You ask if his coach even knows that he's out there on the ice. You tell him to have fun on the bus ride home back to the A. If that doesn't work, then you can go after the guy's style. You go after the way that he looks. You call him a duster. It's all pretty minor chirps that are just trying to get into the guy's head a little bit. You go right for the, I'm going to fuck your wife? Well, now you got a fight on your hands. So who needs to get their ass kicked for this implied cuckery? Well, looking at the guys on the ice at the time of the crime, it looks to me like the only player who could have this thought come across his brain would be Michael Delzato. The only issue there is that he would have to match with the buddy's wife on Tinder first before he fucks her, and I just don't really see that as a feasible option. Now, clearly, it sounds like the chirp is coming from the Canucks bench. It looks like it's getting picked up by the ref's mic there. There are just way too many people there, and we'd have to get the FBI involved to kind of sort out where that sound came from, whose mouth was moving at the right time. I just don't have that technology at my hands right now. But I think what we can all agree on when it comes to the guys who were playing last night, the only guy who's going to be fucking anybody else's wife there is Jaromir Jagr. And at that point, you got to let the man do it. Now, moving on, we've got the most expensive overtime goal that you'll see all season with Connor McDavid and Leon Draisaitl teaming up to send the Islanders home. Over the summer, McDavid signs a $12.5 million contract extension that kicks in next year. Same summer, Leon Draisaitl signs an $8.5 million contract extension. That's going on right now. So this is what $21 million in overtime can get you.
The puck for Barzal, and here's an opportunity. McDavid and Draisaitl. Letty back. Draisaitl moving in. Drop pass. McDavid scores! Connor McDavid, overtime!
A lot of people are going to give Picciarelli grief for those contract extensions as the years go on. But that little one-handed dish from McDavid, followed up by the spinorama, no-look, backhand assist from Draisaitl. I mean, that right there makes $21 million all worth it. Fucking sick. Elsewhere from that game last night, it's time to put Matty Barzal on the all-hands team. Didn't quite finish this one off here, but what a fucking beauty of a dangle. And speaking of dangles, let's talk about the dangle of the night. Pierre-Édouard Bellemare, Vegas Golden Knight, serves this one up to Jeff Petrie on a dish. And you can bet your sweet ass that that pun is 100% intended. Picks up the loose puck along the boards, slams on the brakes on Drouin, then he takes Petrie to the prom, saves him the last dance before stuffing this one home on Lindgren. But the Canadians, they'd hold on for a 3-2 win, and now do we maybe have a goalie controversy in Montreal? Charlie Lindgren, the first Habs rookie goalie in the last like 50 years to start off his career with 5 straight wins. That sound you just heard, that's Mark Bergevin's pants hitting the ground as he's getting ready to trade Carey Price for an over-the-hill defenseman who might have about 6 months left of his legs. Buckle in, folks. And then finally, there's clearly no love lost between the Anaheim Ducks and the LA Kings. This one had a little bit of everything last night. There was a late hit.
Curtis McDermott comes from the backside and lowers the boom, and it's the shoulder into the head of Andre Kasha. It's a 5-minute major penalty.
There was a little mini tilt with a 2-shot knockout.
Jumped Jared Boal, but you know, Boal squared up, and Andreyev got the gloves off early.
There was a cross check straight to the dome.
Here's the battle boy. That's a high stick. And there's not much question about that. And there's a cross check as well. Boy, that could have been a couple of penalties.
And then, of course, there was the Ducks blowing a 3-1 lead and losing the game in overtime.
Goal line. Kings take this away. A potential 3-on-1. Martinez trailing the play. Brown puts it across. Shot, score! Kings win in overtime.
And that's going to do it for today's shift. Time to dump and change.
Let's go. Let's go. I won't fight.
Dance for me, Gino. Dance for me. I'd kill you, Gino. You better talk to Jimmy. Get me on board, buddy.
Come on, Reeves. Help me, Reeves.